I played at my best and got really good.
Three, two, one, go!
Max? Early kills on the Smashville platform, man.
Is anybody good at syncing up game cards? I have no idea how to do this.
I'm so bad.
Help.
Yeah, did you turn it off after you give that little paw
put no,
down?
I forgot.
Oh, well now.
Well, I think you guys heard that probably. Maybe. Hungry, hedgehogs.
Oh,
Just a thing,
man. Yeah, no commentators.
You know me or what?
Huh?
You know who I am or?
Yes,
me. Yeah, you commentated with us before.
Oh, that's right. But I don't know. Yeah, I don't recognize you.
Oh, I'm Slush.
Slush. Oh, you're Slush. Yeah. Jesus, nice to meet you, Slush.
Hello.
But yeah, he's finally coming back.
The mic's unmuted.
Yeah, the mic's unmuted. So we get to go.
All right, what's up, everybody in chat? This is wrapping up for the end of the match between Fun Crazy Fish and Espy.
I know they were commenting about how Espy was struggling because they did. Tesh did mention how Espy worked had a commanding lead in the first game, but he did lose. The header spike completely threw him off guard, and then kind of fell through on the end. Thankfully, he brought it back in the game too. But when it comes to this, Espy's still struggling. I know that one little Sun Salutation got him really high up in
really
there. Like he could have DI'd out of it, but he couldn't. He still got Star KO'd out of it.
Judging the reaction to this, everybody's pretty tense. Everybody's having a good time. He's going for the forward air. He's gonna try to get him off the side of the spring.
Oh yes, that's what I was talking about in the first.
Recover it. Recover it.
This offstage shenanigans is pretty.
And there it goes.
Throughout most of the first match, where Funk Crazy Fish was just offstage constantly trying to header and upbeat all the time, but Espy kept timing